Connors has just managed to intimidate all those youngsters in front of him. Will Novacek be intimidated? We'll find out. He's the number 10 seed. And for Connors, obviously the toughest test yet in this unlikely odyssey towards perhaps yet another U.S. Open final. Boris Becker is out of the picture on his side of the draw. So that gets all the Connors fans all excited because they know that can only help his cause. Jimmy Connors making his way through the tunnel into the stadium court. I think you can expect a fairly generous welcome for this terrific performer who just seems very much at home on this court every time he steps on it. And they'll await Carl Novacek before they introduce the two players.
Hello, Mr. Mayor.
Hey, buddy.
How are you, sir?
I'm
How
fine.
You doing?
Hey, Dougie.
You well?
I'm fine. They tell me that Greg says that the number, you got a new number or something.
Yeah, I'll give you my new number.
Okay. And he apparently couldn't get you.
Yeah.
So?
I like this day. This heat.
Well, look, it's slightly less humid today.
Yeah, it's a good day today.
I know you'd rather be playing at night.
No, I'm happy in the heat.
Really?
Yeah, sure. I'm young. I'm ready. I'm ready for this.
What you're doing for a lot of old guys.
Enjoying it.
You don't know what old is.
Yeah, I love it. I love it.
I'm old.
Hey, 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 hey.
How are you? How are you doing?
I'm okay. Yeah, I'm coming to call and
Carl Novacek of Czechoslovakia somehow doesn't have the same number of well wishers. The welcome for Jimmy Connors, the mayor of New York, no doubt counseling him on how to hit the forehand. The mayor's backhand a little suspect. Perhaps Jimmy can help him with that. Carl Novacek, and knowing full well this entire crowd, with the exception of a few friends and relatives perhaps, and some fellow Czechoslovaks, will be cheering for Jimmy Connors today. Now let's check in at the press conference where Boris Becker is meeting the media following his stunning defeat at the hands of Paul Haarhuis.
With my health, but I have to go back and really find out what exactly is wrong. And you know, maybe then I can get better and I can be good for yeah.
Sitting here right now, is there a real possibility you won't play Davis Cup in your mind?
Yes, of course it is.
Can you say a few words
about
anything
before
I play today?
How I play today? Well, Paul played smart. You know, he saw that I couldn't run from corner to corner, and that's how he played. He was not going for the winners. He was going for left, right, left, right, and he knew that I would be always half a step, two steps slow. And yes, he played smart. What?
Many players have been tired because they have a similar injury. Why do you complain? Is it first not being
tired? You know, I just have a hard time once I'm on the court to give up. Even though if my health is not perfect, I still somehow in the back of my mind believe I have a chance to win. And that's why.
Boris, with you out of this side of the draw, if Connors wins today, would you be surprised if he ended up in the semifinals?
Well, Boris Becker having to go through that painful routine of explaining an upset loss to members of the media, but he is a class act, always has been a total professional since the time he came on the tour as a teenager, and so he's having to put up with that very difficult time. And it sounded like the injury to his leg was a factor in the match today. Well, there is the man taking center stage. He is the king of the U.S. Open, and you'll see him when we return. We're back at the USTA National Tennis Center in New York City, our shot from the blimp of a sold-out stadium awaiting Jimmy Connors and Carl Novacek on stadium court. And for further word on the Boris Becker loss, let's go now to Andrea Joyce.
Well, Tim, apparently Boris Becker injured his right thigh in the first round. He said he would get up in the morning, it would feel better, and then after practicing or playing, it would feel worse again. And he said by the time he got out there today, he was just two or three steps slow, and he just couldn't run. And he says that's why he lost the match. Now, as Connors is getting ready for this third round match, let's send you upstairs to Pat and Mary.
Andrea, thank you. I have to believe you have to give a lot of credit to Paul Harder.
I do too,
Pat. He played very well.
Yeah, this has been a sort of a recurring injury for Boris Becker, although he said in his press conference it was more towards the back of his leg. Mm-hmm. But still, I just don't think emotionally and mentally he was ready to win that match anyway.
Well, let's Becker's out, the number one seed. What about what's about to transpire here in the stadium now with Jimmy Connors? Do you think he has the stamina, the capability at the age of 39? His birthday is on is next week. Do you think he has the what it takes to go further, or what do you think?
Well, I do. I really think this is a winnable match for Jimmy. Only if he can stay close with Karl Novacek. I mean, the man he plays does not have nearly the credentials that we just saw from Jimmy winning 5 U.S. Open titles, among many others. But the fact is, if Jimmy can stay with Karl Novacek right from the start of this match, stay on serve, and allow the crowd to wash over him and take him in, I think it could really intimidate Novacek.
What about Novacek now? What kind of player is he, and what is his reaction going to be to the crowd?
Well, he has won 4 tournaments this year. That's more titles than any other guy on the tour. One of them on hard courts, though he's mostly thought of as a clay courter. He's a brute, is what Karl Novacek is. I mean, he's a very physical player. He muscles the ball around a lot. He's very, very fit as well. And of course, Connors doesn't want to go a long match with this guy. But as I said, I think the circumstances can overwhelm Novacek if Connors hangs tough in the beginning.
You know, Jimmy has played twice, won twice, played at night, hopefully, and it was certainly cooler than the high humidity we've had throughout the weekend. How about today's weather?
That can't be a help to Jimmy at all. I mean, it is very, very, you can see the humidity is rough. The temperature, fortunately, the sun isn't directly out on the stadium court, but it's tough conditions. It's very, very clammy out here. And that will hurt Jimmy.
Well, it's been an amazing year for what they like to call themselves mature athletes like Nolan Ryan, like Jimmy Connors, like people like that, who refuse to let the erosion of time.
Well, you know, age doesn't ennoble every athlete.
No.
But this man, it certainly seems to have done that. Sometimes you see boxers and you think, boy, don't take another punch. You know, what are you doing out there? You know, that happens. But in the case of Jimmy Connors, as long as he has this kind of heart, as he says, look, if somebody's going to take the ball from me, I'll pass it around. He says, but I look around and he says, that ball is hot. And as long as nobody's going to take it, I figure I'll stay around.
Well, you know, the other muscles obviously do deteriorate, but that has nothing to do with the size of your heart. And he's got a big one. I talked to him last night. I told you earlier. And he said, I'm just not sure myself how much longer that I can keep up this pace, how much longer I can go on. But I think he said that as sort of a defensive measure, because I think he really believes he can.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I do too, Pat. The problem is, obviously, Connors wants to have his big moments in the Grand Slam events.
And I think the
biggest problem, of course, is that he is almost 39 years old, and it's difficult to ask a man of that age, even though, he's very, very fit. He always has been. He's always paced himself well. He's never overplayed. But for him to win 7 3 out of 5 set matches in the course of 2 weeks is a very, very tough task.
You know, one of the officials here at the U.S. Open Tennis Center, the National Tennis Center, said to me that we get requests from various participants as to what time they want practice time, and they said the earliest guy, the guy who wants the most time, and the guy who wants the earliest time has always been Jimmy Connors.
His opponent, Karl Novacek, has not nearly the record as Connors, the only man who has won and will ever win the U.S. Open on 3 different surfaces, clay, grass, and hard. This man, in fact, is 0-3 at the U.S. Open. He's never gotten past the first round until 1991.
And no one plays the crowd and uses the rest of the players play. Connors performs.
Quiet, please. First set. Connors to serve. Quiet, please. Thank you.
Jimmy will serve. Far court.
Ready. play.
Chair umpire Bruno Ribot. I don't know if Connors knows him, but I'm sure he'll introduce himself before we're through.
30-15.
That is a rare occasion, an ace by Connors. He wins the first game, first
game
set.
Connors, first game.
And now, this tournament summary, sponsored by AT&T, the right choice.
To summarize, number one seeded Boris Becker lost in straight sets to Paul Haarhuis. Both the McEnroe brothers, John and his brother Patrick, lost long matches, Patrick to Jimmy Connors. Four of the women's seeds have lost in the third round. So indeed, it is the U.S. Open, and it's still very open. Looking down at the stadium, at the USTA's National Tennis Center, and you can see what the presence of Jimmy Connors does. It's starting to fill and will be full. He won the first game, first set. Novacek to serve.
Wants the whole match to go like that first game, no rallies. Paul Novacek, as I said, sort of a poor man's Ivan Lendl. Connors doesn't want to stay around on the baseline with this guy. What he should do is really mix it up, speeds, angles.
I like that last point. Make Connors work. Make him run.
You can't out-hit him.
Connors won the first game, first set, 15-all, second game. Third round action.
Thank you.
Only the fourth U.S. Open for the server. It's Jimmy Connors' 21st. Second on the list, only behind Vic Satius, who played in 24 U.S. Opens. National championships, I should say. Wasn't open when he was playing. And already early pressure. John Lloyd and Vitas Gerulaitis are watching on, both good friends of Jimmy Connors. Connors played on John Lloyd's LA Strings team tennis team for 5 weeks this summer. They got to the final.
He says that helped him a lot.
It's the first ace of the day. They lost the Atlanta Thunder, the team Martina Navratilova played for. She's coming up next against Pam Shriver.
Deuce.
Connor said when he was out with his wrist injury last year and Billie Jean King called him up, she's a commissioner of that league, and said, do you want to play? He said, yep. She's the only one who believed in him.
Well, he says...
A lot of people believe in him now.
Right. He says she was one of the few people who did.
Yeah.
I felt I owed her something in return. That's why he played team tennis.
Pretty loyal guy, this guy. And again, he only played three matches in all of 1990, so he needed to play some. He was voted the rookie of the year.
That's wide.
Novacek holds.
One all.
Pancho Segura in white, who's coach. Jimmy
in the white hair.
The white hair, that's right. He coached Jimmy for a long, long time. And Ilie Anastasi, who won the U.S. Open in 1972 and also a real good buddy of Jimmy Connors, and says of this man, he's got the one thing that we all want, one more chance.
Games are one all, first set.
Novacek and Connors have never faced one another, but Connors said because he's been doing television commentary the last couple of years, he's seen this guy play a lot. And that too has helped Connors game, because he's gotten to analyze these players, get to see what they do. He says, quite frankly, that he doesn't like watching a lot of tennis. He's no fan like Nastasi is, who's out there all the time. Novacek, who is such a clay courter, is going to have to, it's going to take him a while to get used to this hard, flat ball of Connors with no spin. He's used to a lot of topspin. He's not going to get it from this guy.
Just looked up at that hazy sunshine as if it were bothering him. And once you start looking for excuses, you start to explain why you lost. Let's go to the grandstand.
Connors leads by 2-1.
Well, Pat, thank you. Here, Pete Sampras, the defending champion, in the first set against 6'4" Frenchman Stéphane Simeon, who's serving, trying to send the first set to a tie break. Simeon serving at 30-15, 5-6. Youngest winner ever of the U.S. Open, Pete Sampras, straight sets a year ago, ran Andre Agassi. What do you think of Semien so far here, Tony?
Well, he's got a good serve. He's a big guy, as you mentioned, 6'4". Watch when he lands, having hit his serve, he's almost to the service line. Big reach.
Game, Semien.
Tremendous wingspan at 6-all in the first set. Break. 6 aces by the man from Lyon, France. Semien had to go through a three-match qualifying just to make it to the main draw, and here he is in the third round.
This is the 12-point tiebreak. The first player to reach 7 with at least a 2-point advantage will be the winner of this first set. Semien went to the University of South Carolina, played number one singles for him for 2 years in 80-89 and the 89-90 season. You know, with the Sampras demeanor, you always look like he's pretty lackadaisical, and sometimes I don't feel he comes out and turns the screws quickly enough. You know, really try to get ahead and break the first set open. He cashed along on his serve, winning easily, and the other kid just fought and fought and fought, and here they are in a tiebreak. Matter of fact, Sampras just saved a break point in his last service game. This is a big kick second serve from the lefty.
Sampras takes one off the Semien serve. 2-1 Sampras.
He got over the top of that ball very nicely, prepared behind it and got the racket hit over the top of the tennis ball to bring it back down.
Semien, Tony, is ranked 257th in the world.
And his prize money, career prize, been $9,888, so he's had been around long.
Almost returned that one over the grandstand wall. 3-1 Sampras.
One of the things that Semien's been trying to do, which I don't quite understand, is on Sampras's first serve, Semien starts behind the baseline and he walks in, he gets in about a yard inside the baseline, and that's pretty tough. Tough way to try to handle the first serve.
Pretty courageous against this tremendous server. Called that one long. It looked like it was on the line.
They've corrected it. You watch as Semien comes in here. This ball is called out and then immediately corrected. It was a good shot, and it's a tough break for Semien because he was in the driver's seat. He was at the net. Sampras' shot had come up.
3-1 Sampras.
Wayne McEwen of Australia is the umpire. And so he just explained it to him.
He'll play it as a let.
Right. And that's a bad break for the Frenchman who now lives in Lyon, France.
3-1 Sampras.
4-1 Sampras.
His third ace here in the first set. Tony, you picked Sampras to successfully defend his title here at the U.S. Open, but an injury-plagued year since winning here a year ago, but starting to come on here in August.
Well, that's one of the reasons I would not have picked him a month and a half ago, but he's had good success the last three tournaments before the Open. He won two and was a finalist in the other one, and he's injury-free. That's a key. So he's happy and he's playing well.
4-2.
All right, Sampras. Ace number 7 for Semien. They'll switch sides now. 4-2 Sampras.
Our next match here after this one is between Wheaton and Martin. So Sampras, if he advances, should play Wheaton. Ball goes well. And then you see Masur and Emilio Sanchez, Yared and Courier. So an interesting part of the draw. Some pretty good American tennis players in that set, too. Remember what many years ago they were saying, what's happened to American tennis?
Just a whole bunch of them now.
Fine return there.
5-2.
Yeah, really, that Sampras. One quarter of the draw, Tony, with Courier, Wheaton, and Sampras. And only one of the Americans will survive if things go as expected to the semifinals here. 5-2 Sampras, first set tiebreak. Good aggressive play by Simeon. Bit of a do or die kind of an effort when you take that return a serve so early. Five-three, Sampras. Second serve. Right in the corner, very, very close. Simeon doesn't like the call, but he was diving for the ball. Watch him here. He's diving. Pretty hard to tell. It appeared to be right in the corner. When you're 6-4 and can't reach it, it really threads the needle. He doesn't like the call. He'll serve now. Sampras, a point away from the set. First set,
7-6.
7-3 in the tiebreak for Sampras.
Two mistakes.
And the defending champion and sixth seed claims the first set.
When he came back and hastened
me. Out on the stadium court, the man that has captured most of the attention this week so far, James Scott Connors, continues. He's on in there against Carl Novacek. Let's return to Pat Summerall and Mary Carrillo.
All right, Tim, and you, I think you can see from overhead that view what kind of magic he has and how much he has captured the hearts of New York City and maybe America. Jimmy Connors, birthday coming up next week. 39 years old and still running and fighting.
John McEnroe has
15.
You know, he speaks of himself as sort of this aging player, and when that was mentioned to Connors the other night, he said, yeah, if he's talking that way, please have him come. He said, have him talk to me. He said, I was playing my best tennis when I was 31, 32 years old. My very best tennis, he said. Novacek still has not adjusted at all to the fact that Connors' ball stays low. This man, Novacek, as I said, grew up on 15, clay courts 14. And is used to a very high contact point. He's not getting it. He's made a lot of errors off both sides.
Connors has always had the great service return. He's always had the greatest eyesight in the game. He sees things so well. Quick reflexes. Connors up 4-1 in the first set. And has a break point. He's broken him. Connors has broken Novacek once.
Deuce.
Just about full now. Break point for Jimmy Connors. Now that sends you down to Andrea Joyce.
Gam Connors.
Well, Pat, there's an awful lot of activity down here underneath Stadium Court. Just about 20 yards away from me is the court attendance room, and they are responsible for keeping the players supplied with plenty of cold drinks. They've got lots of soft drinks and water and sports drinks, and they also are in charge of the white towels that you keep seeing, and it's a very simple process. Basically, what they do is that they take the towels and they keep them soaking in ice water until the changeovers, and then they rush them out to the players to help keep them cool, and I guess you guys would agree on a day like this, they need all the help they can get to stay cool. Back to you guys.
Thank you, Andrea. When they get through with the players, send them up here.
Where you at? 30 love.
30 love. Second ace by Connors.
Didn't go in too fast, but it couldn't have been better played.
40, love.
Connors has never been known for a big serve, but he sure knows how to move it around the box.
Janet first set, Connors.
First six set goes to Jimmy.
Motion.
Amazing. Really, he won it 6-1. The U.S. Open of 1991 at the USTA's National Tennis Center in New York City. Connors and Novacek. Connors has won the first set. Novacek serving. Earlier today, the number one seed, Boris Becker, upset.
15.
So Becker's out, and, you know, who knows about what Connors can do.
Becker's out. He's at the top part of the draw. Peter Korda, the 15th seed, he was out in the first round. Andre Agassi is out of Jimmy Connors' part of the draw.
Connors lost only 1 point on his serve in the entire first set. And as you pointed out, Mary, he's not known as a big, powerful server.
He's being helped so much by Carl Novacek. 19 errors now from Novacek.
15, Felton.
Here's where we are, third round action. Connors and Novacek trying to advance to round number four.
And even if Connors has to play Aaron Krikstein, a very tough player who beat Agassi in the first round. He's 5-0 lifetime against Krikstein. As we've been saying, you know, it's not inconceivable.
No, it's not. Sampras, the defending champion, playing over on the grandstand right now, won the first set in a tiebreak, 7-6, and leads 2-love in the second. First game, second set. Connors won the first handily. Game to Novacek. And we'll be back at the U.S. Open after this word from your local station. At the stadium, Jimmy Connors serving. Love won second set. Connors won the first set 6-1. I'm sure Jimmy welcomes the fact that the sun has now disappeared behind the clouds.
Everything's going right for Connors right now, Pat. Not only the relative cool out here right now, but the fact that he's playing such a clean match against a guy who just still hasn't figured out how to hit the Connors ball. And Connors shot scoot off this court. Novacek is taking them late. He's got to 30. He's got to get a little more lift into his shots. Novacek, give a little bit more air to the ball. And he wants longer points.
30.
All. And Novacek now showing some signs of life for the first time really in this match. Connors won the first set 6-1.
It's Carl Novacek's wife, Maya, and she's used to watching him win. He was on a 10-match win streak coming into the U.S. Open. Of course, he's won two more rounds. He's much better than he's playing right now. Again, I think this is just a very intimidating court to be playing Jimmy Connors on.
Well, the whole atmosphere, the reaction that Connors has gotten from the whole... from the whole crowd, like that.
Again, Connors.
Again, before kickoff. CBS is coming, covering the NFL when I was playing. It's scary. And over in the grandstand, Pete Sampras, the defending champion. After winning the first set in a tiebreak, leads Simeon 3-1 in the second set. Here, Connors has won the first set 6-1, won all in the second. Service ace by Novacek.
15-0.
There's Neil Pilsen on your right, the head of CBS Sports, and behind him, the last word before kickoff, Greg Gumbel. Used to be here at the USTA's National Tennis Center the last word before liftoff because the planes were such a distraction. That's all been corrected. It's all been changed. And really, I haven't noticed any disturbance or any reaction by the players, thanks to the cooperation of the city and the mayor, who's an avid tennis fan. One all, second set, 40-30. Novacek serving. Connors won the first set 6-1.
Quiet, please. Thank you.
And that's what Novacek, he's just going to have to stop giving Connors so many gifts. Game point for him.
Check. And he leads 2-1. Second set. Connors won the first set. Connors won the first set, serving at 1-2 in the second. Late call, but out, I think. No?
I think the fans called that.
I think you're right. I'm sorry.
15-all. Ladies and gentlemen, once again, would you please be quiet during the point? Thank you.
Thank you.
He inspires fan participation.
Yeah. Jimbo just had to throw his racket.
15-30.
Novacek has got a little bit better feel for the for the Connors ball now, hasn't he?
Yep. Jimmy needs a little bit higher octane to get to that one.
It's the kind of points Novacek wants to be playing. That's his style.
The long one. Like
yeah, he's a grinder.
Well, the guy on the other end is a grinder also. Always has been.
30 all.
It's actually one of his more favored phrases.
I grinder?
I had to grind it out. I ground it out.
Grandstand. Sampras up 4-2 in the second, set up a break after he won the first set in the tiebreak. The legacy of Jimmy Connors.
Cam Connors.
All-time U.S. Open record. Chris Everett has won 101 matches of 113 tries, but that even that doesn't beat Jimmy.
My please.
94 match wins.
My please. Thank you.
For a men's player, he was seeded 17 consecutive years here at the U.S. Open from 1972 to 1988.
Not seeded this year.
A wild card. He needed a wild card to get in. This guy, Connors, is ranked 174 in the world.
Not to itself.
Love 15.
I don't know if the heat's bothering him or not. Do you, Mary?
Not yet. It's early in the match.
First service, quite please.
Love 30, I'm sorry. Connors trying for the service break. He broke Novacek earlier in the first set to coast to a 6-1 win. Novacek has narrowed that statistic a little bit. The unforced errors.
Oh. 30.
Off the backhand, it seems that Novacek is mistiming that flat, low ball of Connor.
30, 40.
Gets behind him.
I think he's, in addition to that, I think he's very impatient at this point. Going for too much.
Again.
Yep.
Advantage Connors.
The break point Connors. Second time for him. And he's got the crowd obviously very much behind him.
Novacek has played in this kind of atmosphere before, and he didn't fare well last year at the French Open. He was playing a Frenchman in the stadium court there, packed round of 16 match against Thierry Champion. And he was way up. I mean, he should have won that match. Had 2-1 and really choked in the tiebreaker. And then Champion beat him in the fifth. It was really one of the worst chokes I'd ever seen. Fourth ace against Jimmy.
Advantage Novacek.
2-2, second set. Connors has won the first set.
Novacek,
not a popular call, but nevertheless, he wins and leads 3-2 in the second. The stadium at the USTA's National Tennis Center, Jimmy Connors serving. He has won the first set 6-1. He's serving 2-3 in the second.
15 love.
That's wide. Carl Novacek. Yankees in Toronto. Nothing, nothing in the sixth. Miami, Florida over Arkansas, 31-3 in Little Rock. Tears to follow. Jimbo, 3-3 in the second. Let's go down to Andrea Joyce.
All right, I'm down here with Helena Stasi, who played doubles with Jimmy Connors for about 6 years. He's wearing Connors' champion blue ribbon.
Best single champion.
As you're watching him play out here this week, are you wishing that you were out there?
I'm very lonesome. Yeah, I want to come back, but I don't think I can do what Jimmy does there. It's fantastic, and you know, even if I have to pay my ticket, I'll do that. Just to come watch him.
You've been calling him old man throughout the match. Are you as amazed as so many other people are that he's been able to play this well just a couple of days before his 39th birthday?
I am a nut. I think, I know Jimmy since he was 17. I think it's when he's out there, he gives his best. I mean, he gives 110%. And to see him playing that long and that close to the net is fantastic. And I just wish somebody can tape these matches and show to the kids how they should play the matches.
So what about all these rumors that you're going to be his next coach?
I'm his coach, maybe.
His couch?
Yeah.
All right, let's send it back to Pat and Mary.
Be careful, Andrea. That's dangerous country.
Love cover.
3-3 in the second set.
Nice what Nastassi says about Jimmy, isn't it? No, they should tape these matches and show them to young kids and say, this is the way you play these matches.
Full of admiration.
Yeah.
What a talent he was. We'll cut that out of the tape. Still break point. Vitas Gerulaitis will be announcing throughout the tournament for the cable network that joins us in our coverage. National Tennis Center in New York City. That's the grandstand up in the upper part of your picture. Pete Sampras, the defending champion, playing over there. Jimmy Connors has attracted the throng into the stadium. His opponent is Carl Novacek. Connors won the first set 6-1 and is up 4-3 in the second. He looks tired, Connors does, but don't be misled.
That's the only real 15. Difference about Jimmy's game from 20 years ago. And as you can see, he's just holding serve so easily. Novacek still hasn't figured out how to return the flat ball.
Do you think the different racket has something to do with it?
Well, that's what Connor says, but in a way I don't even agree with that. And 20 years ago when Jimmy Connors was playing, he was the hardest hitting guy 15. On the tour. I mean, he hit harder than anybody. Now he's just one of the guys. Jimmy says it's because of the rackets. I also think that the game has gotten more physical. I mean, these guys are a lot bigger. The rackets have something to do with that. But in fact, he's got to make some concessions to age against guys like Novacek, so he does have to keep the point shorter, come to the net more. In fact, I think a lot of parts of his game have gotten better over the years.
Well, I remember when we first started watching him, our colleague Tony Trabert would say the only purpose of his serve really wasn't a weapon, it was a way to start a point. Now it's gotten to be a little bit of a weapon.
30-all.
There are plenty of guys who with much bigger serves than Jimmy. I mean, it's not often that he gets it over the 100 mile an hour range. If he can stay around there, I mean, that's pretty good for him. And there are plenty of guys who can pump it into the 110s, 15s, 20s, even 30s. But what Jimmy can do so well is position himself for the beginning of a point with his serves, because he does move it so, around so well. And he follows it up.
Let's say, Mary, that he does win. There's the
14-13.
The book or the speedometer on his serve. How long do you think he can go on?
Why should he stop?
Why should he? I agree with you.
Yeah, that's the thing with Jimmy. I think he continues to look around and say, now these guys aren't that good. They're not that much better than me. My game holds up.
Game Connell.
He's still like a backboard. He gets everything back almost that he can get to. Watch Novacek.
Connell leads.
He's just getting so frustrated now. Again, this is the first time he's played against the Connors ball.
He's going to have to call for an earlier limo.
Well, one of the reasons I think Michael Chang was so bothered by Jimmy Connors at the French Open. He finally won that in the fifth after Connors had to retire. It's because it was the first time he had to play the Connors ball. And it's the way Jimmy hits these days. It's like trying to read a dead language. Novacek is a clay courter. He's used to all kinds of topspin, a much heavier ball, not the kind that hits the court and scoots by. Thrown off his timing.
For years, people have said, he's got to change this. He's got to roll over the top of it. He's got to do this. He's got to do that. But
yeah, he really listened to him, didn't he?
Yeah. Look at his book.
I think that's what he takes great pride in, the fact that at the age of nearly 39, he can go out and play the very best guys. And he says, I like putting my game up, see how it matches up against these guys.
He hasn't written the last chapter yet. This is by no means the only action taking place here at the first weekend of the U.S. Open. The stadium court. The defending champion Pete Sampras up. And a lot of other action going on out on court 16, 17. And all throughout the area.
Connors leads 5-4.
Connors leads 5-4. Second set. He won the first 6-1. That 6-1 is up 5-4 and serving in the second. That's the second serve.
15 love.
Connors continues to keep his play very clean in this match. But again, he's playing a guy who's been extremely generous in giving points away. 40 unforced errors from Carl Novacek, the 10th seed. Conchita Martinez is on a collision course with Steffi Graf. And I have a feeling that might be Steffi's first real true test of this U.S. Open.
Thank you.
15 all, Connors up 5-4, second set after winning the first 6-1.
Again, this is an example of what a nice tight net will do for you. If it had been a little looser, that might have bobbled over onto Novacek's side of the court.
This is a very, very big set for Jimmy. I see some signs of fatigue.
Well, you were speaking with him the other night. He suggested as much, didn't he?
Yes, he did. He just said, I'm not sure how much longer.
Why, please?
I can
Thank
go
you.
On.
He was lucky to have had, after that tough five-setter against Patrick McEnroe, such a simple time of the second round. Sure wouldn't mind taking this in three straight. He's got himself a chance.
40-30.
For a two-set lead.
Someone said, whatever the complement of towels is here, if U.S. Open 7,000, I think I heard. Someone said he went through 3,500 in the match against Patrick McEnroe. To love.
Gammon second set, Connell. 6-4.
Standing up.
Connell slits by two sets to love.
In Connor's very famous match against Michael Chang at this year's French Open, there were six standing ovations in his match, and then later on that week when he was doing television and the fans noticed him up on the balcony getting ready to call the match, they gave him another one. So put him down for seven standing O's.
He missed it.
15 love.
But again, as he has gotten older, Jimmy, he's more and more he's willing to go to the net to finish the points, to make them shorter.
Well, he almost has to, doesn't he?
Yes, but it's actually helped his game. I mean, he seizes the opportunity quicker in a point.
Well, he's always been a fine volleyer.
Novacek did nothing with that smash, did he? He just put it back in the court. Connors was able to stay in this rally.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, would you
And after a good lob, a defensive one, Novacek
Thank
misses.
You.
Fifteen-all. You talk about statistics.
It's not one we've always kept.
No.
Fifteen, 30. Quiet, please. Quiet, please. Thank you.
Continues to fool Novacek with his change of pace
15, 40.
And depth.
But how much longer can he fool his body? Amazing. I mean, you think about Nolan Ryan, I mentioned. You think about Muhammad Ali. You think about the champions, the classics. He certainly belongs in that 30, category. 40.
He says to himself, I don't know what keeps me playing. I could say the standard things. I enjoy the game. The money's good. But I don't know, really.
Connors has won the first two sets. 6-1 and 6-4. Deuce in the third.
Novacek giving him so many breaks, four unforced errors in this game.
Tough second serve coming right here. But a good one. Connors wins the first game, third set, and we'll be back at the U.S. Open after this word from your local
paper. First game.
You can see the presence of Jimmy Connors has stacked this place full. He's won the first two sets and is up 2-1 in the third and serving.
And in 10 service games, Connors has only lost 11 points. Novacek just seems totally overwhelmed by this situation, doesn't
he? Really does.
Just about every player who ever plays in this stadium always talks about how it dwarfs them. How of all the stadiums in the world, this one's the biggest. This one is endless, and you look up into a sea of faces. It's just about the right size for Jimmy Connors.
Yeah. He's been here before.
Last time he won a Grand Slam was in 1983 here, where he beat Yvon Lendl. He beat him here in 82 as well in the final. He beat Bjorn Borg in 78 on this hard court. He'd beaten Borg in 76 on the clay courts of Forest Hills.
Connors It's almost like you just wait when they get into a rally like that. Well, how soon is he going to hit it into the net? Or Novacek, I mean, and how soon might he hit it out? Sanchez advances. I don't think that surprises anyone.
The first time Jimmy won the U.S. Open was back in 74. That was on grass.
Rosewall?
Yeah. Rosewall was 39 at the time.
David Connors.
Jimmy's a couple of days away from 39.
I remember that well. He just overwhelmed Rosewall.
Back in? No.
Well, he had beaten Rosewall that summer at Wimbledon as well. Killed him there.
Connors leads by 3 games.
3-1 Connors, and third set.
As Connors says himself, it's taken me 20 years to become a dangerous floater in the draw.
15.
Which is what you could call him right now.
Took him 20 years to get to be 39. Maybe longer. It is amazing. Forget, as Tim Ryan said a moment ago, we're on till 6, coming up here in the stadium after this. That's 6 Eastern time, of course. Martina Navratilova against her longtime doubles partner, Pam Shriver. And over in the grandstand, Wheaton and Martin. There's a lot of tennis left.
40-15.
Stadium court, Carl Novacek against Jimmy Connors. Dave Novacek.
3-2.
3-2 in the third. Connors has won the first two sets. Outside the stadium, the beginning of a great weekend here at the U.S. Open for tennis and for the surroundings. Earlier today, 2:15 Eastern time, Jennifer Capriati. Some autographs and some enjoyment of her success. And in the meantime, in the stadium,
15 love.
James Scott Connors won the first two sets against Carl Novacek. He leads 3-2 in the third and 15 love. A little conversation with that Lions person. Not necessarily inviting him to dinner, I don't think.
Five, please.
At the stadium court, the U.S. Open of 1991 at the USTA's National Tennis Center. And Connors continues to amaze. He won the first two sets and is up 3-2 in the third. Earlier today, the number one seed, Boris Becker, was eliminated by Paul Harhus. Connors' opponent, Carl Novacek, as Mary Carrillo has said before, never has quite figured out what is it I'm supposed to do against this guy.
Even 2.5 sets later.
Right. Let's now go to Andrea Joyce.
four games to two.
All right, I am with Isaiah Thomas and Joe Dumars of the Detroit Pistons. And Isaiah, as one of the more mature players in the NBA, I don't want to use the word older, how impressed are you watching the even more mature Jimmy Connors?
Well, I'm very impressed. Terry Bradshaw and I were sitting over there talking, and I'm amazed at the shape he's in and how he was able to maintain his shape and his physical stamina. I mean, it's very impressive. Play a 2-3 hour match.
Joe, the Pistons have made some changes this summer. Edwards is out. You got Orlando Woolridge. What do you think will be different?
I guess we're trying to get some younger guys, get more energy on the court. We got a little tired last year, and I think they're just trying to retool everything, get us back ready for next year.
Might be able to get Jimmy Connors. All right, thanks a lot. Back to you guys.
All right, Andre, thank you. Those two guys can really play.
Yeah, they may want to. Detroit might be looking for some older guys. Get Kareem back.
30-15.
Will Chamberlain's around here.
Yeah, always is. He loves this game. One sport I never could picture Wilt, a great basketball player, you know, loves to play tennis, volleyball. I just, somehow he, and he became very interested in polo. I just couldn't see, he was bigger than most of the ponies.
Connors leads 4-3.
Jimmy Connors, who won the first two sets, is up and serving 4-3 in the third.
15.
They've been out there just over an hour and a half. Rippling his hair right now. That's helped Jimmy a lot.
This is his first daytime match. Normally, you're not asked to play more than one or two night matches here at the U.S. Open. They have night sessions and day sessions.
Well, he's played twice at night already.
Well, he's requested them, and
yeah,
he was given them, and it's been good for him. And, of course, it's been good for the fans who've been able to watch him play.
30.
That's only his second double fault of the day.
Very rare. 30-15.
It is rare, Pat, because he really, as we've been saying, this guy has never gone for that big of serve. Jennifer Capriati, serve for serve, serves a lot bigger than Jimmy Connors. A bunch of women do. As the fans are exhorting Connors to close this thing out. 2 points from a 5-3 lead in the third set.
As you look at Terry Bradshaw of the left, Pat O'Brien of the NFL today.
That was a Novachuk.
Yeah.
And in fact, he's been Novachoking, if you want to be more to the point. He misses this. It really was a terrible idea because Connors had all kinds of time. It was not a well-played drop at all, was it?
5 feet. Thank you.
The racket was more effective than his shot. Connors up and serving 40-30, leading 4-3, third set. Connors up 5-3, still to come.
Full chance.
Martina Navratilova against Pam Shriver here in the stadium.
Connors leads 5-3.
beat us.
You heard Connors say, where is Vetus? Beating, of course, Vetus Gerulaitis, longtime close friend. Novacek serving at 3-5 in the third.
There's Vetus Gerulaitis. He's been calling Connors matches this week. John Lloyd sitting next to him. Connors stayed at Vetus' house out on Long Island for 3 days last week.
Double fault. Second by Novacek.
He changed rackets in that last game. It sure hasn't helped. He needed to change opponents. His wife, Maya, I think we'll be heading to the locker room pretty soon.
Double again.
Love Cody.
Still match point.
Five, please. Five, please.
An hour and 40 minutes. Deuce. Connors is up. He won the first two sets. He's up 5-3 in this one.
Advantage Novacek. Quiet, please. Thank you.
Jesus. third one this game.
Advantage Connors.
Love it and he loves it. Connors wins in straight sets. Right now, let's send you over to the grandstand and Jim Nance and Tony Traber.
Here, Pete Sampras is trying to make it a straight set victory against Stéphane Simeon from France. We're in a third set tiebreak. 2-2 in the third set. Sampras having won the first two sets.
3-2.
Simeon now 3-2. Sampras to serve the next two. Tony, your thoughts so far on this match?
Well, Sampras has served fairly well, but he's been erratic off the ground and somewhat lackadaisical. That is his style. And it would make you a little nervous. I don't think this kind of a match should go in two tie breaks and three sets, but that's what's happened.
4-2, Simeon.
You're playing a big guy that's got good reach. He's awkward in ways. We got a good serve, and you don't get any feel. You don't get any rhythm, but Sampras is ranked so much higher that he should dispatch a guy like this more easily than he has. And now he's serving at 2-4 in the tiebreak in the third set.
Can Sampras, the defending champion, the sixth seed here, Simeon, ranked 257th in the world, have to go through a qualifying to make it to the main draw?
Sampras serving 84% this set. That's what's kept him in it.
Double fault for Sampras.
5-2,
Simeon.
It's just what you don't want to happen because, you know, all of a sudden you're in a dogfight. You're now it's 2-1. The big Frenchman says, geez, maybe I can wait, beat please. This guy after all.
Nice backhand for Sampras.
5-3, Simeon.
Here's another look. You watch Sampras get this return early. Gets over the top of it and gets a real good angle.
6-3, Simeon.
So three set points now for the Frenchman. You know, Tim, when you play to win this thing, Jim, seven matches overall, it's just, you know, you just want to grind it out as quickly as you can and get in the locker room.
6-4, Simeon.
Sampras saves one of them, 6-4, Simeon. Two more set points for Simeon. There it is, third set to the qualifier.
Simeon, 7-6.
Hundred and 19th time Simeon has come to the net. Good deep approach. Not a bad try by Sampras, but he's out of position, can't recover. And Simeon wins the third set.
Two sets to one,
Sampras.
We'll hear from Jimmy Connors when we come back.
Okay. Jimmy, congratulations. Is this about the most fun you've ever had playing, getting this kind of crowd support?
Well, I don't know if it's the most fun, but it definitely ranks up there among some of the best. But, you know, for the people to come out and still enjoy the way I play, it's a lot of fun. But, you know, I'm giving them what I've given them for 20 years, which is in everything I have. And, you know, kind of we got a good balance going right now between the crowd and myself. But, you know, playing the good tennis is what matters.
This is the first match you had to play during the day in the heat. How concerned were you about that?
Well, I'd rather not, but then again, I'd rather be, one hand is going to take a lot more out of me, but on the other side of the coin, it's going to loosen me up a lot quicker and, you know, kind of get me into the match faster. But, you know, if I can come off winning three sets like today and, you know, get home and get some good rest for another day or two, then by the next round, I should be ready.
Your quarter of the draw has gotten so interesting. There are no seeded players left. Agassi's out, Becker's out. What do you think?
Well, I think I can't worry about them. I've got to go ahead and worry about myself, but if it opens up a little bit and gives me an opportunity to sneak in somewhere, that's even better, but I still got to go out and play the good tennis.
You're making an awful lot of noise. I don't think you're sneaking.
Well, as long as the people come out and enjoy it, that's good, but you know, the matches and the tennis and the tournament to date has been really something, and if it continues for the next week like that, it'd be great.
Congratulations. Thanks again.
Typical of Jimmy's positive view. He looked at the heat out there and said, well, on the other hand, it helps me warm up more quickly, and therefore I get into the match. That's the reason this guy's such a great champion. He can find that kind of sunshine no matter what happens out there.
All right, Pat, this match perhaps close to ending at the grandstand. Sampras leading 2-1, and Sampras leading here in the fourth set, 5-2. We're at 15-all. Simeon serving.
And I wouldn't think that Sampras will be pleased with his performance today. He felt he was playing well, but he really hasn't played that well today. Obviously happy to get out with the win. I think that Pete needs to come out smoking a little bit more. Just, you know, right off the bat, try to get ahead of these kind of players and bury them early. Sampras actually was only broken, and Simeon served twice. He broke it for one love lead in the second set, and it held up. Then he broke it in this fourth set at 3-1.
15-30. Now we've got double match point.
2 hours and 43 minutes. They've been on court.
Pete never had his serve broken today. Two wins in August for Sampras, one in Los Angeles, and then he won in Indianapolis, knocking out Forrest Becker in the finals. His first two wins since last year's Open victory here.
You know, he suffered from shin splints, he had some blisters, he had a ruptured right calf muscle, a pulled hamstring muscle. And so those are things that he fought. He said he probably played a little bit too much after he won here last year, and his body just sort of broke down on him a little bit.
Got another match point here.
Good gambling second serve that time by the Frenchman. Thank you.
Advantage, Sampras.
Sampras goes under this return of serve, pulls it down the line, and the placement was the key there. Watts' early preparation. Though he put a little backspin on the ball, he drove through it, so he had some forward thrust.
Just like in the Steffi Graf match that preceded this one, Simeon able to hold off a few match points. Back to deuce.
That's good work. He huffed and puffed, but he got back to knock that deep topspin lob off. This was a miss hit, had a lot of top. You see him backing all the way up, and he did a heck of a job to get that kind of pace on the smash. Good wrist snap at the last minute.
And a save for Simeon. That's the game for Sampras him now. 5-3, Sampras will serve for the match. Big man here from Lyon, 6'4". Just turned pro in January after getting a degree at the University of South Carolina.
That's about the way he's been trying to do it the entire match. He tries to block the Sampras return serve, get in, and hope that he can fluster Pete.
He has not, however, again, broken Sampras's serve the entire match.
1-37, a tiebreak. Seaman was hoping that the serve would be called out. He sort of made eye contact with the linesman, asked me, said, yeah, it was good.
30 love.
Probably the one bright spot in this match for Sampras when he reflects on it will be that he has served well. He hasn't been broken at all. But I don't think he'll be pleased with his stroke production, the success of his ground strokes and returns of serve. Too many mistakes.
Triple match points.
I've had the feeling throughout this match that Sampras feels like he can win it anytime he wants, and it's a dangerous attitude, I think.
Ends it with his signature. The service ace. Guess he felt like it that time.
That's all right.
On to the round of 16 for Sampras. He awaits the winner of Todd Martin and David Wheaton, who will be next up on the grandstand. 2 hours, 49 minutes, Sampras in four. And let's go back now to Tim Ryan.
Well, all right, Jim. Not the best performance so far in the tournament by Pete Sampras, but beating the qualifier Simeon, moving along. His first two matches, he was much more efficient than he was today. But nonetheless, he's the defending champion, and he's now into the round of 16 with a victory over the young Frenchman, a qualifier, Stefan Simeon. Here's a look at the draw. He awaits the winner of the match coming up. David Wheaton is also in fine form. He's playing another American, Todd Martin, and hopefully we'll get some of that action for you here before we go off the air. We still got lots of time. What time is it? 5 o'clock. We got another hour with you this afternoon, and we'll be back at the U.S. Open after this word from your local station.
You have been playing your best tennis of the year this summer. Do you feel like you're going to be peaking at the right time next week?
Hopefully. I play the winner of David Wheaton and Todd Martin. My first two rounds, I thought I played much better than I did today. I was playing a guy I'd never seen play before. I've never really heard of him. And I kind of struggled a little bit in the third set, and I really didn't return quite as well as I would like, but I served well and folded out.
Weren't even sure of his first name.
Well, he qualified, and obviously he was playing good tennis. He won three matches and beat Fleury and Curran, so obviously he was playing good tennis.
How different has this experience been for you to return as defending champion?
Well, it's certainly much different than last year. Last year I was kind of working my way up in the ranks, and to come back and having the expectations much higher than last year was a bit difficult. But, you know, if I just worry about playing my tennis and not worry about the situation, not playing for, you know, the press or the fans, just play for yourself, and that's what I've been trying to do.
Forrest Becker, of course, was in your half of the draw. How shocked were you by what happened to him this afternoon?
A bit shocked. I saw a little bit of the match, and Harhus obviously plays quite well in New York and beating McEnroe a couple years ago. And, you know, I saw a little bit of, and, you know, Becker really didn't seem like he was really into it, really fighting. And, you know, it's tough sometimes, you know, a lot of pressure on you, and Harhus really had nothing to lose, and he lost the match.
All right, good luck in the next round.
Thank you. Okay.